My name is Joanna Osmanska. I'm a clinical research fellow at the University of Glasgow. And I present the results of two early phase clinical trials investigating use of subcutaneous furosemide in patients with heart failure. So the most important thing is that we've used a new preparation of subcutaneous furosemide, which is pH neutral and is highly concentrated preparation containing 30 milligrams of furosemide in 1 mL. So that allows to administer dose of 80 milligrams of furosemide in 2.7 milliliters, but also we presented the results of a first-in-man use of novel subcutaneous patch infusion pump, which has been specifically designed to administer the treatment. The first trial was a PKPD trial. It was a phase one trial, a single dose trial, randomized controlled trial with a crossover design. And in this trial, 80 milligrams of subcutaneous furosemide was administered using conventional infusion pump. The active comparator was 80 milligrams of intravenous furosemide administered as a bolus. The inclusion criteria included patients with a heart failure, any ejection fraction, and NYHA class 2 and 3. In the second trial, we used the same preparation of subcutaneous furosemide. It was a phase 1 single dose trial where 80 milligrams of subcutaneous furosemide was administered using novel patch infusor device. This trial included patients admitted to the hospital with decompensated heart failure who required treatment with intravenous furosemide at a dose of 40 milligrams or more. We've accepted patients with any ejection fraction. So the key findings in terms of a PKPD study is that the subcutaneous furosemide in comparison to intravenous furosemide achieved a bioavailability of 112%. The natriuresis and diuresis were comparable, so the clinical efficacy of subcutaneous furosemide was similar to that of intravenous furosemide. In the patch infusor pump, we've proven that the device is safe to use and there was no device failures. The diuresis effect was similar to that in PKPD trial, and natriuresis effect was of 97 millimoles per liter, which is above recommended 70 millimoles per liter as per ESC statement. We've also proven that the device is well tolerated by the patient. Novel preparation of subcutaneous furosemide has been proven to have similar clinical efficacy in terms of a natriuresis and diuresis to intravenous furosemide administered as a bolus. In preliminary phase one trial, we've also shown that 80 milligrams of subcutaneous furosemide administered with a patch infusion pump has been safe and well tolerated by the patients. So the next steps would be a randomized controlled trial investigating new treatment strategy, subcutaneous furosemide in comparison to intravenous furosemide, and we'll plan to start this trial in June 2022.